There are over 10 million electric vehicles, or EVs like they're fondly called, parked in several garages and roaming different streets across the world. What does this tell you? The world is slowly drifting away from conventional gasoline engine cars and embracing the efficient, eco-friendly, and more quite often called EVs. Electric cars are touted as the future of the automobile industry, but the truth is, they've been around for as long as you can imagine. Yes, even before conventional engine vehicles. You've probably seen an electric vehicle dash past your street, or maybe you've had the rare chance of riding in one. Oh, sorry, perhaps you own one of the 10 million EVs mentioned earlier, but do you really know how it works? This video will cover everything there is to know about electric vehicles from the inception to date and why they're marketed as the future of the automobile world. You should wait till the last second because in the latter part of this video, we will be explaining on the technologies that ensure you have a smooth ride in your EV anytime you feel like it. We'll also examine how electric cars have surpassed traditional automobiles in terms of performance. But first, how about a brief backstory? Electric vehicles have a long history, dating back to 1828 when Hungarian priest and engineer Ignaz Jedlik developed an electric motor based on his dynamo electric concept and used it to power a mini car. Over the next 25 years, other inventors such as Thomas Davenport and Professor Sibrandus Stratting, together with his assistant Christopher Becker, built different versions of the electric vehicle. However, these models were plagued with different issues. Davenport's prototype was designed based on Jedlik's dynamo electric principle, which wasn't fully developed yet. And Professor Stradling's small electric car sample was powered by non-rechargeable primary cell batteries, limiting the car's distance and speed capacity. But thankfully, in 1859, French physician Gaston Plante invented the lead-acid battery, a lasting solution that goes on to revolutionize the EV industry. Around three decades later, between 1887 and 1891, the Electrobat, an electric vehicle that can house six passengers and reach a top speed of 20 miles per hour, was invented by William Morrison in the US. This represented a huge breakthrough for EVs. By 1897, the streets of London and New York were littered with electric-powered taxis, and in the early 1900s, around 33% of the cars in the US were powered by electric motors. But still, the plagues returned to haunt them yet again. EVs at the time were slow compared to what we enjoy now and could only run short distances because they needed charging every now and then. For instance, Morrison's Electrobat required charging every 50 miles, meaning the batteries must be recharged every 4 hours if it travels at a top speed of 20 miles per hour. This limitation, coupled with the invention of electric starters and mufflers, which helped reduce the noise from combustion engine cars, threatened the existence of further development of EVs. The final blow was delivered in 1910, when Ford began mass production of gasoline engine cars, which made them cheap, giving them an edge over EVs. Automobile companies and consumers were forced to abandon the EV dream. Fast forward to the 21st century, tech advancements and concerns for the environment have led us right back to electric vehicles. Presently, EVs are lauded as the future, with the European Union possessing a new policy that will see fossil fuel emissions from new vehicles drop by 55% in 2030 and 100% by 2050. Some automakers such as Ford, Renault and Volkswagen are also committed to this policy, meaning we could see 30 million electric cars and 80,000 eco-friendly vans across Europe within the next decade or so. But before we delve into what electric cars are, let's unravel the mystery behind batteries. A battery is a device containing electrochemical cells. It stores chemical energy and transforms it to electrical energy. Batteries have two electrodes, anode and cathode, and another part called electrolyte. The movement of electrons in a battery produces the current that is used to power different devices ranging from the TV remotes to cell phones and even EVs. Electric vehicles, or EVs, are clean emission automobiles that are powered by an electric motor instead of the traditional internal combustion engine. Instead of fuel tanks and several hundreds of moving parts such as valves, pistons and crankshafts, EVs have lithium-ion batteries and about 150 moving parts maximum. Electric vehicles function on the principle of magnetism. As a rule of thumb in magnetism, like poles of a magnet would repel each other, on the other hand, opposite poles will attract. So how does this work in an electric vehicle? Let's say two magnets are placed within close range, one in a static position and the other attached to a rotary device, something like a motor. If the two closest poles share the same polarity, say south to south, the magnet on the motor will be repelled, causing it to spin until the north pole of the motor's magnet faces the south pole of the static magnet. When this is done, the rotary device or motor in this case becomes still. Going by the picture we just painted, the motor has turned 180 degrees, or you could say it has successfully completed a half revolution. But that wouldn't even be enough to get your car out of the garage. This is where electromagnets come in. Unlike regular magnets, which have rigid poles, electromagnets allow magnet polarity to be reversed. Now let's swap the static magnet in our early example with an electromagnet. When the two nearest poles have similar polarity, let's say south to south, the motor's magnet turns 180 degrees until its north pole faces the south pole of the stagnant electromagnet. But instead of standing still, the static electromagnet will reverse its polarity, causing the motor's magnet to make yet another half turn. Now it's time for the inverter at the rear of the electric vehicle to make its grand entry. Since batteries can only supply and accept a direct current, DC, the inverter, with the help of induction motors, converts the direct current from the batteries to alternating current and uses it to spin the flow of electrons around multiple times per second. It is this process that propels an electric vehicle. Because electric cars produce more torque, they do not require shifting or torque converters. Gearbox and levers are also missing in electric vehicles. Aside from batteries and inverters, they also feature other components such as induction motor, thermal cooling system, electrical transmission, and onboard charger, which plays different roles to ensure they're more efficient than gasoline engine automobiles. When they're static, you'll probably not be able to differentiate both. But as soon as they're in motion, the gasoline engine vehicle announces its presence with a loud vroom sound and the CO2 emissions that pop out from its exhaust pipe. On the other hand, electric vehicles give off little or no sound at all. Traditional internal combustion engines can weigh up to 600 pounds. Meanwhile, the motor in a sophisticated EV like the Tesla Model S weighs only 70 pounds and produces 362 horsepower, but it's powered by a 1,200 pound battery. Electric vehicles use a single speed transmission to transmit power from the induction motor to the wheels, converting electrical to mechanical energy. Furthermore, EVs are known to charge themselves when they're not in motion. There are three charging levels available for electric vehicles. Level 1, trickle charging. Level 2, charging. And level 3, or DC charging. These levels determine how long it would take to recharge your car's battery. Level 1, or trickle charging, can be done at home by plugging the EV's charger into a standard 120 volt socket. This is relatively slow though, as it adds 3 to 5 miles of active time to your battery per hour. Level 2 charging is the most common charging level for electric vehicle owners. The Level 2 EV charging equipment could be installed in private homes, neighbourhoods, or other public places like malls. This method supplies around 220 to 240 volts, depending on the charging equipment, adding between 12 to 80 miles running time per hour. The last and most efficient method, Level 3, or DC charging. Unlike the first two levels, DC charging supplies direct current, which refuels around 80% of your battery's capacity in less than 30 minutes. Before we proceed further, if you've made it this far, make sure to like and subscribe for more content like this. The world is increasingly becoming more conscious of pollution and climate change. To tackle this, we need to use cleaner forms of transportation to reduce the amount of emitted greenhouse gases, hence the need for electric vehicles. Considering all you've learnt from this video and the European Union's policy to reduce the amount of carbon dioxide emissions significantly, will you be looking to purchase an electric vehicle soon? Be sure to check out this video over here about the inside of the world's biggest passenger airplane ever built.